Oh, I remember one time, Sister Miranda and I, we got here. Most of the church was sick, amen. And nobody was here that night. Miranda, me, and Caden wasn't born yet. I had Michaela, Joe, Nathan, and Miranda all on the front. Miranda said, "Honey, what are we going to do?" I said, "It's 6:55. I don't see nobody here yet." Miranda said, "Well, maybe we can just have a prayer meeting and then we'll just go home after that." I said, "Well, I got a message. I'm preaching tonight." She said, "Okay, honey, you're the pastor. Well, let me tell you what happened. I got up here, I'm looking down at the crowd, and none of you were here. It's just my small family." I said, "Hey, I want you guys to spread out so it looks a little better for me." Oh, and I said, "Let's stand and let's open up in prayer." Nathan looks at Josiah and starts laughing. Amen. Like, we're so silly. We're the only ones here. We're having church. Amen. Oh, I just said, "Lord, just have your way tonight. Move by your spirit." Amen. Oh, I begin to sing that song. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful. Blessed be your name. Oh, in those barren places. Amen. Oh, about that time, one other brother came in here. Wasn't looking around. Who wasn't here? Just came in, lifted their hands up, started praising the Lord. Amen. Wasn't worried about who was here. They come with one purpose, to worship the Lord. Can you say, not too long after that, a little girl come into this church. No mother that wants anything to do with her. Has a daddy that's buried in some cemetery somewhere for being shot 10, 15 times in the chair. No brothers, no sister. Feels totally abandoned. But here she is in the front. She's got tears in her eye. Her hands are lifted up to Jesus. She's finding strength. She's finding comfort. Say amen.
Amen.
Oh yes. Worship. Amen. Many have no problem worshiping God with their lips. Amen. 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 Now we went to a fellowship meeting at Brother Noel's church and I enjoyed myself. I didn't know hardly any of the songs. Amen. But I knew they were singing for Jesus. Amen. And we just lifted up our voices with them when we could, amen, when we kind of got familiar with it, and we just worshiped with them, didn't we, amen? Why? Because we weren't waiting for the conditions to be right. We weren't waiting for our song, quote unquote, to get sung. How many of you know what I'm talking about? Oh, but we were saying, "I've come tonight on a Monday night. I've come to worship God. I've come to get my praise on. I've come to hear from heaven tonight." And anytime we can come with the spirit of expectancy like that, God will never fail you. He will come and bless you. Can you say amen?
Amen.
I'll share this with you, and then I'll be done. Those. A lady, really wasn't a lady, the whole entire family, went to the church and if I'm up there leading songs, you know, my dad is the pastor. He's still the pastor over there, but I'd be leading songs, everybody standing, clapping, worshiping the Lord, everybody's happy, except for one family. Amen. Sitting there like this. You know. Hey, I'm not saying everybody's going to do the same thing when they worship, but I'm saying never one time open up their mouth. But if it was that person's turn, or one in the family to lead the praise and worship, it was, "Everybody lift your hands. Why aren't you praising the Lord? You all need to start worshiping like me." You know what I'm talking about. Oh, they don't ever want to get involved, but they want to crucify everybody else. Worship God. Amen. You see, church, all they were doing was giving a bunch of mouth. Amen. Giving a bunch of lip service. But God says, "I ain't interested in the lip service. I'm interested in the heart. What's going on?" This morning, as every head is bowed and all the eyes are closed, Brother Randy, would you come, my brother? Let's just lift up our hands up unto the King this morning. I know this is a little different message today. Some of it's been a hard message, but I'm telling you, it's just from the Lord today. Amen. It's just from the Lord. And whatever God has for me, that's what I want. Can you say amen? Sometimes the doctor gives you a medicine that don't taste all that good, but it's that medicine that can save your life. Can it? Amen. And I'm telling you, sometimes God gives us a difficult word to endure, a difficult word to take down or to swallow. But God says if you'll take it, if you'll apply it, I'll do something in your life so extravagant and extraordinary. You would have never thought it'd be impossible before. All you've got to do is heed that word. Can you say amen? Hallelujah, hallelujah. God told Ezekiel to eat the word. Didn't mean to rip the pages out and to eat it, but to spiritually eat it. In other words, eat it, read it, and let it have its effect on your life. Amen. With every head bowed and all the eyes closed within this house today, are you here today? And you say, Brother William, I need to confess to God today. There's been too many times in my life I've been honoring God with my lips. I've been saying the right things. I've been saying my amen on cue. I've been saying my hallelujah every now and then. But it ain't been coming from my heart. And today, I just want to make it right with God today. I want to worship Him in spirit and in truth. May you just lift up your hand today. Nobody looking around. Just say, I want to worship God like that. I want to worship God with all my being. I don't want to just sing words. I want to sing from my heart. I want the joy of the Lord to be my strength. Maybe you're here today and you say, Pastor William, I've been honoring God as far as my lips go, but my lifestyle has not been living according to the Scripture. Let me tell you, God's calling to repentance today. He's saying it's time to surrender unto me. It's time to totally just give me your all and all. God is a jealous God. He loves you, but He doesn't just want part of you. He wants all of you. How many of you would agree? It would be unacceptable for a husband to say to his wife, you can have 99% of my heart, but this other girl's got 1%. We would all lift up our hands, wouldn't we? And we would say, that's totally unacceptable. That woman should have all of you or none of you. But many people do that spiritually to God. I'll give you 99%, Lord. But this 1%, I'm still going to love the world. I'm still going to act like the world. I'm still going to talk like the world. I'm still going to think like the world. Oh, God says, I can have all of you or none of you. The choice is yours. You hear today and you say, Pastor, I've made up my mind. I'm making things right with God. I'm giving up those secret sins. Nobody else may know about them, but God does. And today it's time to make it right. If that's you, I just want you to make your way up here to the front today. Let's just believe God today. Let's believe God. He loves you. He's a patient God. He loves you. He cares for you. But at the same time, He requires all of you. As you require total faithfulness from your husband or your wife, God requires total faithfulness of His bride. Hallelujah. I'd like us all in here. Let's find a place to pray. Maybe you need special prayer. Just let us know. Amen. We'll believe the Lord to touch you. Let us pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We are in your presence. Fill us with your
I ask you, Lord, that you just continue to touch Him. Continue to anoint Him, Lord, and to use Him for your glory. Lord, I pray, Lord, for physical strength, Lord. Physical strength, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Father, I pray, Lord, for Sister Marlene this morning. I ask you, Lord, that you would just touch her from the top of her head, Lord, to the very soles of her feet. Lord, touch my brother today. Touch my sister, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Touch your people today, Lord. Touch your sons. Touch your daughters today. In the name of Jesus, we give you everything today. All of our heart, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for little Wyatt today, Lord. Just touch my little buddy. In the name of Jesus, touch his mama, touch his daddy today. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for Brother Charlie. I ask you, Lord, that you would just touch him. Touch Sister Joyce today in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for Brother Dave, Lord. Keep your hands up on his grandparents as they're traveling to Hawaii, God. In the name of Jesus, Father, I pray for Sister Beverly. I ask you, Lord, that you would just touch my sister. Supply her needs, Lord. Lord, just continue to guide her, lead her, and direct her steps. In the name of Jesus.
Genuine worship just turned in to lip service.
No more.
He started just acknowledging God with his mouth, but that heart is far away. He started moving after his own flesh. And God eventually said, I'm going to have to replace you now. I found a man after my own heart. A young man named David. Amen. Oh, but God would say that about you and me. William is a man after my own heart. Marlene is a woman after my own heart. Amen. I want to have the heart of Jesus. Amen. When you have the heart of Jesus, you'll be so loving towards people that are hurting. You'll be so compassionate. Amen. You'll live holy lives. Amen. But when our hearts are not like Jesus, we become grouchy. Irritable. Amen. So those times we just got to get back to the Lord and say, Lord, I'm sorry. I want to have your heart. Amen. Amen. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Let's just lift up our hands. Let's just say, Lord, I don't want to honor you with my lips only, but Lord, I want to honor you with my heart. Amen. Oh, I want to honor God with all my heart. Amen. That's what God is looking for. True worship. True praise. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just come to you in the name of Jesus. And I ask you, Lord, that you would just be with your people this afternoon. I thank you for this service. I thank you for everyone that was here, the praise, the worship. Lord, I ask you, Lord, that you just continue to strengthen Sister Mary today. Lord, just miss Sister Mary today. We all do. I ask you, Lord, that you just strengthen her. Lord, I ask you, Lord, that you touch Sister Joyce. Lord, we miss her. I ask you, Lord, that you just touch her. Strengthen her, Lord. Lord, we look forward to the day when that miracle takes place, Lord, and she's up behind this panel worshiping and praising your name and declaring the glories of God. I ask you, Lord, that you would just be with your people. Let us not be a people that worship you with our lips only, but help us to all worship you with our hearts, Lord. God, we just give you all the praise, all the glory. I pray, Lord, a special anointing
over Sister Miranda tonight, Lord. I pray that you'd calm her nerves. And Lord, just anoint her, Lord, to preach your word. In Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen and amen. God bless y'all. Love you.
We love you too. Thank you. Bless your brother Charlie.
Pastor Williams.
Okay, now you've been
a while. That's my first and last name. William Williams. God bless you, Brother Charlie. Guitar sounds great, Brother Charlie. The guitar sounds great.
Here,
God bless you, Sister Diane.
I don't trust you.
God bless you, Sister Lena.
He's not going to hurt you.
Bless you, Brother Wayne. Bless you, buddy. Oh, what a sweet Lord. Hey, Brother Daniel, God bless you.
I got to go out and talk to you.
Hey, Christina. I'll pay for the certificate. I'll do the ceremony. All I need you to do is show up. That's it.
How do we obtain the certificate?
Let's get together and I'll go down to the courthouse with you, and you'll get a certificate that says Daniel wants to marry Christina. And then once you have that, we can do a little ceremony. We can do it. We can do it over there. We can do it in a pickup. We can do it.
No, we don't want to be here.
You want to be here?
Yes.
When are you leaving?
I'll be leaving on Wednesday.
Well, you guys can get married Tuesday. Monday or Tuesday?
Let's have a wedding on Tuesday. What time? Probably five.
That sounds great.
Tuesday at 5, does that work?
I will get your number and I'll call you back early this Monday morning, but we'll see what all we
need to do. Tuesday at 5, and you can just wear what you're wearing. It don't matter. I married Brother Charlie, his daughter, and him and Joyce's daughter. I married Amanda and Ken at what time was it? 7 in the morning?
Yeah. They said,
we want to get married and we're going out of town. I said, well, I'm going out of town too. I said, it was 6. I said, if you'll be at the church at 6 a.m., I'll marry you. They were there.
Two one zero five five six.
I've got a plan that you got to get married. So,
we're going to do it.
Yeah, I'm not going to do it.
Here, I'll come Wednesday.